mixing. In your textbook, without blending, they mention without blending. The without blending is nothing but a without mixing. Blending means mixing. Without mixing, they separate in F2 generation during gamete formation. Here, statement, the two contrasting characters are brought into F1 generation without blending. In F2 generation, they separate during the formation of gametes. This is the statement of the monohybrid cross. Here, very important. Mono means single, and I will mention two contrasting characters. Here, I will explain about monohybrid, and you will begin understand. So, here, explanation. In monohybrid cross, there are two characters, two contrasting characters. First one, homozygous tall pea plant. Here, tall is a one character, and dwarf is a one character. But these characters comes under height. Height is a main character. Mono, height is a one character. And two contrasting characters, tall and dwarf, are a contrasting characters. That's why I will mention two contrasting characters. Here, parental generation, when we cross homozygous tall pea plant with the homozygous dwarf pea plant. These are parental. These terms are very important. Parental generation, phenotype. First one is phenotype. Phenotype is nothing but a external character, morphological character. Here, homozygous tall pea plant is crossed with homozygous dwarf pea plant. Here, homozygous. I will mention homozygous. Homozygous condition means the identical alleles are identical genes. This is homozygous condition. These two alleles are homozygous. These two are also homozygous. That's why homozygous condition. Here it is genotype. Genotype means genetic constituents. Here genotype always mentioned in the letters. Here T, capital T, and small t. This is genotype. Here gametes. These are the gametes. T, because of homozygous condition, that's why only one gamete is formed. Here, homozygous condition, one gamete. When fertilization takes place, gametes, here, syngamy or fertilization. Fertilization or syngamy. When fusion, two plants of F1 generation are gets crossed. Here I will mention heterozygous stalk because condition is heterozygous. This is heterozygous condition because alleles are different. So heterozygous stalk is crossed with heterozygous tall because in F1 generation all plants became tall. And here next is gametes. There are two types of gametes. One is dominant and one is recessive. Here also two types of gametes because the condition is heterozygous. Here only one type of gamete because the condition is homozygous condition. That's why the gametes are four. Four types of gametes are produced. When these gametes are put in a Punnett square, so this is called as a Punnett square arrangement of the gametes in the horizontal and vertical lines. Here, these are the gametes. This tree is input in the Punnett square. It is also called as a checkerboard. Here, the one gamete is T and this T is that one. Next, this gamete is and that gamete. So, when crossing is takes place between these gametes. Here, T, T and T, T. Here, next, T, T and T, T. So, this is about Punnett square and this generation is called as a F2 generation. This generation is called as a F2 generation. So, mention the phenotypic character of this gametes, of this hybrids. Here, T, capital letter T, capital letter P, indication of homozygous condition it is. Yes, homozygous. Homozygous tau. Here it is. There are two types of gametes. Condition is heterozygous. Heterozygous tall. Why it is tall? The dominant gene. Here the dominant gene is present. Here next heterozygous tall. Heterozygous tall. Here also condition is heterozygous and dominant present. Dominant gene is present. That's why it's tall. Here what it indicates? Small t, small t. The capital T is indication of tall and small t is indication of the dog. The condition is homozygous or heterozygous? Here it is homozygous. Why it is homozygous? Same gametes. Small t, homozygous. But the dog, the plant became dog. Here this is about F2 generation. Next is about the phenotypic ratio and genotypic ratio. Here phenotypic, and I told in previous class the phenotypic meaning and genotypic meaning. Here phenotypic means external morphological characters, the external characters of the plant or any organism, and genotypic means genetic constituent of the organism or plant. Here, phenotypic ratio. Phenotypic, external character. And second one is genotypic. So, external character. How many plants are tall in this checkerboard or in this Punnett square? Here also tall. This is also tall. This is also tall. So, that's why three. Three are tall. And next, how many dwarf plants are present in this square? Here, dwarf plant is only one. That's why one. Here, one is dwarf. This is about phenotypic ratio. Here, next is genotypic. Genotypic ratio became 1:2:1. How? How many homozygous conditions are present? There are homozygous tall plants are 1. Here 1. And heterozygous talls are present. homozygous stall is to heterozygous stall and is to homozygous dog. Here in genotypic ratio, homozygous and heterozygous is taken into consideration. That's why the ratio became 1:2:1. This is about monohybrid cross. Here the test cross of monohybrid. How the test cross is done? I told what is test cross. The test cross means the crossing of the plant F1 plants with double recessive parents. I told parents are T and TT, tall and dog plant. Here dominant. These are dominant. I told the dominant is always represented in the capital letters and recessive genes are always represented in the small letters. That's why dominant. Here recessive genes and this parent is double recessive because double recessive genes are present. That's why it's called as a double recessive parent. Here also double dominant parent. So next is about test cross. Test cross. The test cross is nothing but crossing of any F1 hybrids. F1 hybrid with double recessive parent. Here F1 hybrid RR became tall and double recessive parent here TT. When crossing is done TT because heterozygous condition the gametes are different, T and small letter T. Here only one gamete is produced. When crossing is done, this T is crossed with this T. And again, this T is crossed with this T. Here, ratio became 1:1. This is test cross. If the ratio became 1:1, that means the hybrids are heterozygous in condition. If the ratio became 1:1, the considered as the hybrids became heterozygous in condition. This is about monohybrid cross. Dear students, next concept is about dihybrid. So di means two characters. Here two characters, I will explain. Two characters are nothing but round and yellow. Round is a shape of the seed. Yellow is a color of the seed. That's why two contrasting characters are more than two contrasting characters. Here statement. Statement of dihybrid is when more than two contrasting characters. In monohybrid, only two contrasting characters are brought into F1 generation. Here in dihybrid, more than two contrasting characters. Here more than two contrasting characters. There are two contrasting characters, round and yellow. Wrinkled and green are also contrasting characters. That's why the more than two contrasting characters are brought into F1 generation. Brought into F1 generation, they assort independently. They assort. Assort means divide. In your textbook, they mention assort. Assort is nothing but a divide. They divide independently by one another. Independently by one another in F2 generation. In F2 generation, during the formation of gametes. Understood? Here, more than two contrasting characters are brought into F1 generation. They assort independently. They divide independently. ಯಾವಾಗ ಇದ್ನಾಗ್ತಾರೆ ಅವ ಎಫ್ ಟು ಜನರೇಷನ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಅಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಆಗ್ತಾವ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಆಗ್ತಾವ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮೆಟ್ಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮೆಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಗೋಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮೊದಲು ಏನಂತಾರೆ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಾವ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಡೈಹೈಬ್ರಿಡ್ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಡೈಹೈಬ್ರಿಡ್ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಟೂ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ ಟೂ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಪೇರೆಂಟಲ್ ಜನರೇಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಫಿನೋಟೈಪಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಫಿನೋಟೈಪಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ ಟೂ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ದ ಸೀಡ್ ಬಿಕೇಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ಡೈಹೈಬ್ರಿಡ್ ದ ಕಲರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೀಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಶೇಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೀಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರೇಷನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಹಿಯರ್ ಒನ್ ಸೀಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಂಕಲ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಸೀಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಸೀಡ್ ಈಸ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಸೀಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಅಂಡ್ ರಿಂಕಲ್ಡ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ these two characters are cross here genotypic characters round indication rr indication here r indication is round dominant character here y y indication is yellow here small letter r indication of wrinkled female gametes. So there are 8 gametes, total 8 gametes. These gametes are arranged into a chakargo or spinet square in for getting a F2 generation. F2 generation to work on the end of the tree. F1 generation to parents and the end self cross material. So, how do you know the spinet square or have to do here? Capital letter R, small y. These 4 gametes are arranged into this line. So, these are male. And here, female. The gametes are arranged into vertical and horizontal line. Here, the gametes. Eva gametes are named madandri, spinet square or hypitani. So, these 4 gametes are here and these 4 gametes are here. So, crossing is done. Here, R. R, Y, Y. R, R, Y, Y. R, R, Y, Y. Here, R, small letter R, capital letter Y, small letter Y. Next, it is done. First one is done. Second gamete crossing B. Here, capital letter R, capital letter Y, small letter Y. Here also, same. Arrange the gametes with crossing. R, R, small letter Y. Here, this is done. Next, third. Capital letter R, small letter R, capital letter Y, capital letter Y. Capital letter R, small letter R, capital letter Y, small Y. Here, say R, R, Y, Y. The crossing is made between gametes. null. Here dominant gene Y is present, that's why yellow color is present. Next, here round. Round indication of Y, capital letter Y is yellow. Here round. Indication of small letter is, small letter Y is green. That's why round green. Here small letter R is present. Indication of wrinkle. Here Y is indication of yellow. Here wrinkle. Small letter Y is indication of green. So this is Punnett square. Here arrangement of the gametes is takes place and indication of the character of the seed. Okay, here this is FA generation and arrangement of the gametes in the Punnett square. Here phenotypic character, this is very important. Phenotypic and genotypic characters, here it carry a 2 marks compulsory. 7 marks irukka phenotypic mention maarikku 1 marks irukala genotypic mention maarikku 1 marks irukala. So this is important, phenotypic and genotypic character. Here phenotypic character, how many round yellow present in the in that Punnett square? There are 9 round yellow seeds are present. Here 9, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. So 9 round yellow seeds are present, that's why the 9 ratio. Here is to 3, there are 3 round green seeds are present, that's why ratio became 3. And 3 are wrinkled yellow, 3 seeds are wrinkled yellow, so that's why the ratio became 3. And 1 is wrinkled green. So the ratio, phenotypic ratio is 9:3:1. This is important. Here phenotypic ratio is nothing but external characters. The plants round yellow produce model plants, yes, sorry, ombat plants nava. Here round green produce round green seeds ana produce model plants, yes, nava, mur nava. Here wrinkled yellow plants, yes, sorry, mur nava. Here one plant enadari wrinkled green produce model plant adari. That's why 9:3:1. It is a phenotypic ratio. Second one is about genotypic ratio. The genotypic ratio is like this: 1:2, 2:2, 1:2, and 4:2:1:2:1. This is important. This is genotypic character. Here, genotypic character is nothing but the genetic constituents. So here, round yellow. Here same are present. Round yellow. Here homozygous condition. Round yellow. One seed is only one plant is present. Round yellow. Second, round yellow. The genetic constituents. It is also round yellow. It is also round yellow. But the alleles are different. Here recessive allele is present. That's why these types of plants are only two plants. And round yellow. Here the genetic constituent is different. These types of plants are two plants. Next, round yellow. Here genetic constituent is different. This type of plants are four are present. Compound ring, Punnett square and round ring. Next, round yellow. The genetic constituent is different. So these type of plants are two. Here capital letter, small letter R, YY. Here wrinkled yellow, one plant is present. Here there are two plants are present and wrinkled green, only one plant. Round green, only one plant. Here in genotyping, genotyping and entry, ivella same irbeka, ee letters ella same irbeka, hanta plants yes present avu nodu. This is about genotypic character. So this is about dihybrid cross. Test cross of dihybrid. So I already told test cross meaning and why it is done. Test cross edhuk maadbeka. So it is very important. Exam da kelthare. What is test cross? recurve 3 natural are 1. So ratio is 1:1:1:1. The four plants are became very different. So 1:1:1 is ratio indication of the condition is heterozygous condition. The plants are heterozygous condition. So that's why it is very important test cross. In examination, it will ask for 2 marks question. Take up the some questions, important questions for the examination purpose. Here, write. Question number first, state the law of purity of gametes. Here is 2 marks question. State the law of purity of gametes is nothing but a monohybrid cross. Second one, explain law of segregation. Explain law of segregation. It is 5 marks. Here in this question, you will explain monohybrid cross. Here statement of the monohybrid cross and full detail of the monohybrid cross with the phenotypic and with the genotypic ratio. Second, state the law of independent assortment. State the law of independent assortment. It is 2 marks question. Fourth question, explain the law of independent assortment. This is 5 marks question. Fifth question, write the test cross of monohybrid and dihybrid cross. Next question, write the phenotypic and genotypic ratio of law of purity of gametes. Here 7th question, write the phenotypic and genotypic ratio of law of independent assortment.